I wonder what goblins eat.
They eat people, like you.
Oh dear.
Yeah. little frog.
Thank you.
whole day in this mud.
Ugh, and it shows on my hemline.
Hello?
That flower spoke. Nonsense. Flowers don't talk.
Can you please help me?
Of course, Lady Flower.
Find my sister on the other side of this stump. Are we looking for another flower?
Don't worry, Lady Flower. Let's go.
The heroes had found themselves in a magical forest. Pontius had been quite taken by the ladylike flower they had encountered. Amadeus thought the matter with the flower was some kind of an enchanted practical joke. Zoya didn't think this or that about the flower. We'll wait and see, she pondered.
That flower should have told us more.
Easy. We find her sister.
Yes. Let's interrogate all the flowers in the forest.
Something smells wrong.
That gas cloud. It reeks of death. Better stay away from it.
Thank you. Water.
Maybe we'll get giant strawberries.
I wonder how the water does that.
Is this why the snails and frogs are so big around?
Thank you.
One.
Insects, come to me. I crush your bones and
Catch him!
I hope we can get through safely.
What's this concoction?
Darkness enveloped the marshlands as the night fell. Suddenly, familiar light appeared, illuminating the path.
Where now?
A tree hat!
More like a tree castle. And the Trine wants us to go it.
The Trine could take us to a nice beach for a change.
Let's go inside.
The torches in the treehouse flickered nervously as the heroes stepped inside. It seemed unlikely that the house belonged to a flower, even a clever talking one. But the warmth indoors was a welcome change after a day in the mire.